Welcome back to YouTube. I've been working on the old Ford pickup here last couple days, and I got the transmission pulled out of it. We're going to get the engine off to the machine shop and get started on that. But I wanted to kind of show you what I found in the transmission. The reason I pulled the transmission out, it was shifting fine and everything when the truck was running. But the reason I pulled it out is because it was leaking an awful lot of transmission oil or gear oil. Out of the rear seal where the yoke goes in for the output shaft, and that was obviously unacceptable. The whole underside of the truck actually has a band right above that yoke that's coated in gear oil, and so I knew I had to do something about that, and it looked like maybe the front seal was leaking too, and so I figured I'd pull the transmission out of the truck because it's a lot easier to do it now and the engine's out than in a couple months after the engine's back in. And so I pulled the tranny out, took it into work and steam cleaned it. Could have done a little bit better job, but I just wanted to get the heavy crap off of it. But this is a NP435 four-speed manual transmission. And I've done some online research, and it sounds like they were pretty good transmissions. They were pretty well bulletproof from what I can see, and kind of revolutionized the way that transmissions are built today. They were in vehicles from, I think some of the earlier ones were in the early 60s, and then all the way up through the 80s from what I could see. And because of that, parts are easy to find, rebuild kits are easy to find. You can actually get a remanufactured transmission all ready to go, minus the bell housing and the tail shaft, for like $600. And so that's not really that bad at all. But I took the top cover off of this. This is what they call a top loader. I took the top cover off and looked at the internals, looked at the synchro rings. The synchro rings in this one were brass, and when I drained the oil, I found quite a bit of brass in the oil. And so I thought maybe I was gonna have some issues with the synchros. But I checked that stuff out. For the most part, it looks pretty good. The only thing that I noticed is the main first gear, the gear that also runs reverse on the reverse idler shaft, has some wear on the reverse side. So either people shifting to reverse when the truck's not all the way stopped, or more likely would probably be somebody hitting reverse instead of, I don't remember if it would be fourth or third on this transmission, but somebody trying to swing over and shift into that gear and hitting reverse instead is probably the most likely cause of that. But to me, it's not anything that's bad enough to make it worth tearing all the internals out. The synchronizers didn't look too bad, and so I think I'm just going to put the cover back on, put everything back together. I'm just going to leave the internals alone for now. The bearings all seem to be good, so I'm going to leave all that. The rebuild kit for this is about $250, and so if I can not spend that money, that's the money I can put into the motor. And like I said, it really doesn't seem to me like it needs to be rebuilt at all. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. But now to get to the oil leak in the tail shaft. The first thing I found was when I went to take the yoke off, the big nut that holds the yoke on was like finger tight. The only thing that was holding it in place was a little bit of a mushroom on the end of the shaft. So that was the first thing, and that meant that this yoke was actually sliding back and forth in the tail shaft housing. So I mean, this thing was like not that far off of catastrophic failure, just for that point alone, that your drive shaft and your yoke and everything is able to slide in and out on that transmission. That's on a deal like this where the yoke is bolted into the transmission, that's not cool. You know, on a automatic transmission out of like a Chevy or something, they're kind of made so that they have some slide there, but I don't believe this one is supposed to have that. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Secondly, when I pulled it off, somebody's obviously knowing that there's been problems because this fell out of the inside of it behind the nut. This is a big glob of silicone that somebody must have taken the nut off and just pushed a bunch of silicone in there to try and stop the leak. So somebody obviously knew that there was problems here. But now we get to the meat and potatoes of what the problem is. I don't know how you guys can see that on the camera, but this yoke is actually cracked all the way up through here, into the base of the yoke, around and back down the other side. I could probably take this with my bare hands and snap half of this yolk off. And so obviously, between that and the yolk moving in and out on the shaft, that crack just destroyed that seal that seals the oil in, where this yolk goes into the transmission. Now the other thing it affected is inside that tail shaft, there's a bushing, and that bushing is shot. You can see that was just from me taking the bushing out. That was where I used to chisel, but like I said, I don't know how well you guys can see that, but the inside of that bushing is just, that's supposed to be brass. It's a brass bushing. And so that explains where all the brass in the oil came from. So we'll get a new bushing. Luckily it didn't wear all the way through, so the tail shaft is fine. So we'll get a new bushing, new yoke, and then also inside the tail shaft is this bad boy right here. For those of you that don't know what this is the gear that drives your speedometer. And basically what happened is at one point in time, somebody let that speedo cable get up against the exhaust and it melted that cable. When it melted that cable, it held that cable in place. It wasn't allowed to spin. And so what that did was it took the teeth off of this gear. Once again, I don't know if you guys can see this in the camera, but the kind of the outside teeth here are fine, but as you get towards the middle, it's all wore down. So that's going to have to be replaced. Once again, not really a big deal. It's like a $10 part, but the transmission had to come out of the truck for that to be done easily. The tail shaft, you know, this is inside the tail shaft. The tail shaft has just got four bolts holding it on, and so it could have been done under the truck, but it's just a lot easier to do it when it's out and you can work with it. And then on the other end of the spectrum, the gear on the end of the speedo cable is also going to have to be replaced, and obviously the speedo cable is going to have to be replaced because that's shot. So that's kind of where we're at there. Nothing too major, like you said. It could have been a lot worse. But I'm also going to replace the seal on the front because one, it's easy to get to, and two, I think it was also leaking. Either that or at one point the rear main seal was leaking, which I wouldn't be surprised if that was the case as well. But either way, the inside of the bell housing here was very oily, let's put it that way. The other thing, and I'll try and show you guys this with the camera, all throughout here, that's all rust spots. And I started looking at it, and when I took the engine out of this thing, I actually found parts of roller bearings and stuff laying inside of here, and inside of the dust cover there was roller bearings. And basically at some point, there must have been a clutch in this thing that had a pretty nasty failure. I'm kind of at a loss on that one because I don't really know where in the clutch would have roller bearings in it other than the throwout bearing. So the throwout bearing must have been what took a crap on them. But anyways, these are all nicks in the bell housing from pieces that were flying around on the inside of there. And Lord only knows what else was going on in there at the time. So I haven't decided yet if we're going to bolt the transmission up to the engine before we put it back in the truck, or if we're going to just put the transmission back in and then put the engine in. I'm kind of leaning towards putting the transmission in first, just because with this being a top loader, this piece on the top here sticks up into the inside of the truck quite a ways, and I'm afraid it's going to be kind of a pain to get everything squeezed in there with the engine on it and whatnot. And so we'll probably put the transmission back together, get it all fixed up, and put that back in the truck, just so we don't have any clearance issues. But that's kind of where we're at with that. I'm going to start a separate series for this truck because I'm going to be doing quite a bit to it. So you guys can follow along there, and I look forward to getting this thing back on the road. So thanks for watching. Please leave a like, share, subscribe, and check back for more.